The Mishomis Book, The Voice of the Ojibwe, by Edward Benton Banai. Chapter 10, The Clan System. In our last chapter, we learned how the first Madeoan ceremony came into being. We learned how the water drum came to the people. The Madeoan religion taught the people how to use the powers of the spirit world to treat their sicknesses. The Madeoan gave the people a sense of spiritual strength to be balanced with its twin, the physical side of life. The people were no longer frail and began to live longer, but the Creator remembered how the Earth's people had suffered in the past. He decided that the Earth's second people needed a system, a framework of government to give them strength and order. To do this, he gave them the Odoi Damiwug clans. Ojijok, Crane, Mong, Loon, Gigoon, Fish, Macquaw, Bear, Wabijashi, Martin, Wawasheshi, Deer, Banais, or Bird. Each of these clans was given a function to serve for the people. The Crane and the Loon clans were given the power of chieftainship. They were given the people with natural qualities and abilities for leadership. Each of these two clans claimed to be the original chief clan. They were both given the respect of chieftainship. By working together, the Crane clan and the Loon clan gave the people a balanced government, with each serving as a check on the other. Between the two chief clans stood the Fish Clan. It was sometimes referred to as the Water Clan. The Fish Clan was made up of the intellectuals of the people. They were sometimes called stargazers, since they were known for their constant pursuit of meditation and philosophy. The Fish Clan members would settle disputes between the two chief clans if a deciding vote needed to be cast. This built-in ability of the clan system to resolve differences of opinion greatly added to its effectiveness as a governing body. The Bear Clan served as the police force of the people. They spent most of their time patrolling the outskirts of the village so as to ward off any unwelcome visitors. Because of the large amount of time they spent close to nature, the Bear Clan became known for their knowledge of plants whose roots, barks, or leaves could be used as medicines to treat the ailments of the people. The Martin Clan served as the warrior clan for the people. They provided the force to protect the village at all costs from outside invaders. They became known as master strategists in planning the defense of their people. The Deer Clan was known as the Clan of Gentle People. They were the pacifists. It was said that the people of the Deer Clan would not even indulge in using harsh words of any kind. They were the poets of the people. There are those who say that it was the moose and not the deer who was the leader of this clan. Others in the northern regions of this hemisphere claim that it was the caribou who was the head clan. Eventually, all the clans diffused out into different divisions, but always one animal represented the head or king of the clan. The turtle, for instance, was the head of the Fish Clan. The Bird Clan was the final clan and represented the spiritual leaders of the people. Its members were noted for their intuition and sense of knowledge of what the future would bring. They were said to have characteristics of the eagle, the head of their clan, in that they pursued the higher elevations of the mind, just as the eagle pursued the higher elevations of the sky. So the Creator gave the people the seven original clans to provide leadership in all areas. One of the natural laws that the Creator gave the people along with the clan system was that there was to be no intermarriage of people in the same clan. In this way, the blood of the Earth's second people would be kept pure and strong. It is said that the people of the Deer Clan once violated this natural law and began marrying within their clan. The Deer Clan people were sent warnings. Their children started to be born with defects and abnormalities. They made no correction in their ways. Finally, the Creator was so disturbed by this departure from the way of harmony that he destroyed the Deer Clan in its entirety. For this reason, there are no members of the Deer Clan among the Ojibwe people today. The clan system became an important part of the Madeoan Lodge. Each of the clans was given a function and place in the Madeoan. All the clans were held together by the force of the water drum. It was the responsibility of the Bear Clan to guard the doorway of the Madeoan Lodge. Inside the lodge, the clans would take their position in the order that was given to them by the Creator. After the clan system was given to the people, the seven grandfathers sent seven spiritual beings to Earth to clarify how the clan system was to be used and to amplify the meaning of many gifts often taken for granted in life. The beings came to the people out of the water. They brought many teachings meant to sharpen the senses of the people. It is said that the first five beings brought messages pertaining to the five senses of man: touch, smell, taste, hearing, and sight. The sixth being brought teachings about Amunisuan, or intuition, a special sense that goes beyond the ordinary senses. It was a special sense that few people recognize in their lives. When the people looked to the seventh being to see what gift it was that he brought them, they saw that his eyes were covered by a blind. The people asked the seventh being, "Why do you hide your eyes from us? What have you brought us?" The being answered, "What I have to give, you may not be ready for." The people insisted that the seventh being uncover his eyes. When he lifted the blind from his face, there were shrieks and screams from the people. All those who saw his eyes fell over dead. The seventh being turned and walked back into the water, but he shouted to the people that he would return when the proper time came, if it ever came. Many people have speculated as to what gift it was that the seventh being brought. Most agree that it was the ability to see into the future. Nigoni wa bun gigewan. The people may yet see the seventh being return with this gift for everybody if the time is made right. While the clan system was in power, the Ojibwe suffered no famine, sickness, or epidemics. There was said to be no wars and very little violence in these days when the clan system was strong. In the clan system was built equal justice, voice, law, and order. It reinforced, by its very nature, the teachings and principles of a sacred way of life. It is interesting to think of where our society might be today if the people had held the clan system together in its original form and power.